Welcome to this video on column validation in SharePoint 2013. Here, we'll review several examples of setting up formulas that check the accuracy of your content. In our other videos on how to create columns, you've seen simple column settings that check if a value is unique, if it falls within a range of numbers, if it has a certain number of decimal places, or if it exceeds a certain number of characters. The validation techniques covered in this video let you create rules to check a column's content, which is a far more powerful approach. Validation can be performed on 5 types of columns: single line of text, choice, number, currency, and date and time. Let's start with a single line of text. Here's a custom list called Validation Examples. Click the List tab and create column. Let's create a column called Part Number. Our goal is to check that every part number starts with PN- and is 7 characters long. Define the column type as single line of text. Enter a description, require information, enforce unique values, and define the maximum number of characters as 7. We'll use the default value of blank. Once we expand column validation, we can create our formula. All formulas start with the equal sign. We want to look at the first 3 digits from the left in the part number column and see if they are equal to PN-. To check that the length is 7 characters, we add this to the formula. Finally, we want both of these tests run, so we'll put them in parentheses and join them with an AND. Let's enter a message to help the user if validation fails. Click OK to save the column, and OK to index for unique values. Now, let's enter a new item to test our rule. Click New Item and enter a title of Widget 1. Try entering a 10-digit part number. You cannot enter more than 7 characters, so we know the rule for length equals 7 is being enforced. When we click Save, we can also see that the rule for beginning a part number with PN- is enforced. Let's delete 567 and add PN- to the front. That information is successfully saved. Let's add another item named Widget 2 and use the same part number of PN- 1234. We get a message that it already exists, so unique values are being enforced. The next validation example is for choice columns. In the same list, let's create a column called Manufacturer. We'll make it a choice column and enter a description. Information is not required, nor are unique values. We want the first choice to be Make a Selection, followed by 3 manufacturers: Alpha Incorporated, Bravo Limited, and Charlie Company. We'll use a drop-down and disallow fill-in values. We'll leave Make a Selection as the default value, so the user is prompted to make a selection. Our validation rule will detect that the user actually chooses one of the 3 companies and doesn't use Make a Selection. Expand column validation. Here's our formula. This means that if manufacturer equals make a selection, we want the validation to be false and trigger the user message. If the choice is anything else, validation is true and the value is accepted. Here's the message that will appear if validation fails. Click OK to save the column. Let's test column validation by creating Widget 2 and adding a valid part number. If you skip Manufacturer and click Save, you'll see the user message. So, select Alpha Incorporated and save Widget 2. You can also perform validation on number columns. In the same list, let's create a column called Quantity. We'll make it a number column and enter a description. We'll accept the defaults for required information, unique values, and minimum and maximum values. We want to check that the quantity is a whole number. One way to do this might be to set the number of decimals to 0, so let's try that. Click OK. Click New Item and add Widget 3. Enter 9.8 for the quantity. When you click Save, you'll see that SharePoint accepts decimal values and rounds up to 10. That's not what we want, so let's use column validation. Go to List Settings and click the Quantity column to edit it. In Column Validation, enter this formula. This will check that the value entered in quantity is an integer. Enter a user message and click OK to save the column. Return to the list and delete Widget 3. Now, let's create a new Widget 3. If you enter a quantity of 9.8, you'll see the error message. Enter a quantity of 10 and save the item. Validation for currency works the same as for numbers. Our last validation example is for date and time columns. Let's create a column called Ship Date. Make it a date and time column and enter a description. The remaining default values are fine. For validation, we want to check that ship date is today or later and is not a past date. Here's the formula. This checks that the ship date is greater than or equal to the current date. Enter a user message. Click OK. Let's add Widget 4 and use a ship date of yesterday. The user message appears. Once we change the date to tomorrow, we can save the item. The key to validation is creating the correct formula. If you are familiar with Excel, you can often develop the formula there, then use it in SharePoint. The Microsoft Developer Network contains additional information on formulas. Go to MSDN and search for Calculated Field Formulas 2013, or use this direct URL. For advanced examples of validating complex entries, such as phone numbers, email addresses, or social security numbers, consult this excellent explanation. In this video, we've reviewed column validation for 5 column types. These techniques apply to both libraries and lists. Another type of validation is at the list or library level, where you can compare columns. For example, you can check whether an expiration date is after a created date, or whether the sales price is more than the cost. The video for list and library settings describes this type of validation in more detail. We encourage you to check out our other SharePoint videos, as well as the reference and training materials on the SharePoint Help site. On Connect NCDOT, there is a link to help on every page. Go to the main Help page and click SharePoint Help to see the SharePoint Help information. On Inside NCDOT, there is a link to the help site in the header and footer of every page. Those links also take you to the SharePoint help site. For information on upcoming SharePoint classes, log in to Beacon and check the LMS training calendar, or contact the PC training group. Thanks for watching.